si Drelon, mahilig talaga ito kumontra sa Senado. Ngayon, pakinggan natin mga idol yung debate nitong si Drelon at saka si Manny Pacquiao sa harap ng ating mahal na Pangulo, President Duterte, na kung saan lagi kumukontra ito si Drelon kay Manny Pacquiao at kahit nga sa ating mahal na Pangulo kumukontra siya sa mga panukala. Kaya ating mapapakinggan dito yung sagutan ng dalawang senador. Pero kung bago tayo magpatuloy, kung bago ka lang sa aking YouTube channel, huwag mo kalimutan na i-click yung subscribe. Salamat! So, pakinggan natin yung debate ng dalawang senador, mga idol.
President, I don't think the gentleman from Iloilo understand what is boxing, what is the combat sports, Mr. President. It involves here lives of athletes, Mr. President. Like I said, a lot of athletes died in this arena, in this sport. So we should have a separate commission for the combat sports, especially boxing, Mr. President, for their safety.
Mr. President, yes, I may not understand boxing in the manner that the gentleman understands it, but certainly we understand what government is all about. I cannot understand how the creation of a separate boxing commission will save lives. That cannot be done by the Asian Amusement Board.
It is, Mr. President, it saves lives because makakapag-focus sila.
Okay, hindi mo po pwede mag-focus ang gap, Mr. President?
Mr. President, to focus in one sport is not easy because it's easy to say, but it's not easy to do because especially Gabi handling more than 20 sports. How can you focus in one sport? We have common sense to understand that, Mr. President.
I have common sense, Mr. President.
Handling, I stand corrected, Mr. President. I apologize for my word, but Mr. President, people died here. It involved lives, Mr. President. What I'm talking about is, how can you focus in you are handling more than 20 sports? Yes, maaari, Mr. President.
Maaari po, pagkamali sila. Hindi po ba?
Yes, Mr. President, but the most important thing is we have to trust our authority, which is the government.
No question. We trust our authorities. We trust Senator Pacquiao that it is in good faith that he is losing for the death penalty. We trust our colleagues that they will decide in accordance with their conscience. But all of us are valuable. We can commit mistakes. Is that correct, Mr. Chairman, Mr. President?
It can happen, Mr. President.
It can happen, Mr. President.
There is no perfect in this world.
Correct. In fact, in the history of man, only one can claim infallibility. Would the gentleman know that man?
God, Mr. President.
Jesus Christ. And yet Jesus Christ was a victim of wrongful execution. Is that correct, Mr. President?
Mr. President, it's hard to include what happened to our Lord Jesus Christ because it's purposely, Mr. President, it happened a bit for the saving of lives of many, Mr. President.
I'm sorry?
Lives of many, Mr. President. Purposely, it happened that way, Mr. President.
Are you saying that the execution of Jesus Christ was a correct execution?
Perhaps what the gentleman means is that the redemption would not have been possible if Jesus did not die on the cross. This was a debate that we had with Senator Tolentino and I in 1993.
Because in the Bible says, Mr. President, Jesus said that he can command his angel to protect him. Himself, but he didn't do that because purposely he's going there to sacrifice himself and for us to be saved.
That is the reason the saying that Vox Populi, Vox Dei is correct, because the people wanted Barabbas to be released and not Jesus, because God wanted Jesus to redeem
him. And that is why we believe that Jesus Christ was wrongfully executed, Mr. President, because of the wrong Vox Populi Vox Dei. Anyway, Mr. President. Mr. President, going to the next issue. The gentleman has asserted that it is not a question that the imposition of the death penalty is not a question of constitutionality. Is that the correct recollection, Mr. President, of the speech?
Can you repeat that, Mr. President, the question?
The gentleman from Sarangani asserted that the imposition of the death penalty is not a constitutional issue because, in fact, the Constitution allows it. Is that the correct recollection?
Yes, Mr. President.
And therefore, the debate should be on a question of policy. Is that correct?
No, Mr. President.
Why is it not correct to debate on policy? We are here in the halls of Congress precisely to debate on policy. As correctly pointed out to the gentleman, it is not a question of constitutionality. And I associate myself with that proposition because indeed the Constitution provides that the legislature, the Congress, may provide for a death penalty in heinous crimes. And therefore there is no question that the imposition of a death penalty is constitutional. But is it a correct policy to impose the death penalty? That is an issue addressed to Congress. And therefore the debate should be on questions of policy, not on constitutional. Would the gentleman agree with that?
No, Mr. President.
So what's on? Okay. So what will we debate on if not on policy?
It's already defined, Mr. President, the heinous and other compelling reason, Mr. President.
I'm sorry, I did not get the answer, Mr. President.
Other compelling reason.
Other compelling?
Compelling reason.
Compelling. Other compelling reasons. In other words, are there enough? The question that will be raised is, are there enough compelling reasons to reimpose the death penalty? Is that what the gentleman suggests?
Mr. President, drugs is considered as a heinous, Mr. President, and that's why we're here to debate on that matter for the drugs is heinous or not. But
yes, whether the drug is heinous or not.
That's why in the committee we have a discussion for on that matter, and we should be brought that in discussion on the committee level, Mr. President, the hearing.
Mr. President, when we craft a law, are we not establishing policy?
Yes, Mr. President, we establish policy based on the Constitution.
But the Constitution, Mr. President, allows the imposition of the death penalty if Congress so provides. And therefore, it is not an issue of constitutionality, but an issue of whether Congress, in its judgment, adopts the principle that imposition of the death penalty is the correct policy. Is that correct, Mr. President?
That's correct, Mr. President.
And therefore, we will be debating on policy, not on constitutionality.
Within the scope of the constitutional definition, Mr. President, we will make policy based on we are discussing here under the constitution, based on the constitution, and we make policy based on the constitution, Mr. President.
That's correct. A policy cannot be contrary to the constitution. The imposition of the death penalty is not contrary to the Constitution. But whether we impose the death penalty is a matter that the Constitution dictates will be left to the power of Congress to determine. Is that correct, Mr. President?
Yes, Mr. President, that's why we're here to discuss it about the...
That's correct. We are here to discuss the policy of the imposition of the death penalty. Now, Mr. President, is the gentleman aware that the imposition of the capital punishment of death or grand defacement is automatically elevated to the Supreme Court for review?
Yes, Mr. President.
Now, the imposition of a death penalty is automatically subjected to review by the Supreme Court. Would this gentleman agree with that?
President, I don't think the gentleman familiar understand what is boxing, what is the combat sport, Mr. President. It involves here lives of athletes, Mr. President. Like I said, a lot of athletes died in this arena, in this sport. So we should have a separate commission for the combat sports, especially boxing, Mr. President, for their safety.
Mr. President, yes, I may not understand boxing in the manner that the gentleman understands it, but certainly we understand what government is all about. I cannot understand how the creation of a separate boxing commission will save lives.
President.
So, yun mga idol, yung kanilang nagota ng dalawa na ito, na kung saan na wala talagang parang walang patutunguhan. So hanggang dito na lang mga idol. Kung bago ka lang sa aking YouTube channel, huwag mong kalimutan na i-click yung subscribe. At maraming maraming